So we actually met in high school working at Nordstrom together. We went to different high schools, but we happened to be working at the same place. So she was working retail, I was working in the cafe.
He has a great charm to him, and he'd always sneak me extra chocolates whenever I went to the cafe.
Kind of knew from the jump that I was very interested in her, but I'm actually very grateful that she rejected me very early on.
We stayed friends when we were 16 for probably 10 plus years, and then we realized that we were both single and it was a good time and we were really close.
And that gave us both a chance to kind of go through life before we cross paths again.
He was the first guy that ever made me feel safe and taken care of, and I could see growing a family with him and being with him forever. And I wanted to move in with him after almost like a couple months of dating.
I think it's just a culmination of who she is as a person and, how she reacts to pretty much everything. It kind of solidified that that was who I wanted to be with for the rest of my life.
The day after my birthday, we were having a friends gathering, and he told me that right before dinner, he said, "Let's go just walk by the monument."
And, we're in the middle of the road at this point. I asked her to make a pit stop. She's completely like flabbergasted. She has no idea what's going on at the time, at least. And she's kind of pushing back on me. She's like, "Why? Like, why do we need to make a pit stop? Like, I'm in heels. I don't want to go."
So then he took me to the monument and he got on one knee on the Lincoln Memorial.
I gave my whole spiel. I asked her to spend the rest of her life with me, and she said yes.
It was the best proposal ever.
As soon as it happened, it's kind of like, you just get this weight that gets lifted from your shoulders. I shot up. I gave her a big kiss. We started like, well, I started jumping up in the air because I was so excited.
He's all around a great guy and he is so sweet and caring. But I would say the most important thing is that he will do anything for his family, and I know he will always have my back and hopefully our future children's backs.
She was 16 when I met her. I was 17 years old, and she's never been afraid to speak her mind, to be the person that she is. Especially, being a woman, being a minority, like in this day and age, she never really understood the concept of glass ceilings because she was always shattering them, even when we were younger. And so I have always been drawn to that, and it's what I love most about her.